We've had more lawsuits than ever before. ADF is very happy camping. We're keeping it very good. We had no idea what Planned Parenthood is really about, abortion and all. So, how are we going to do these things? If we're here today, my goal is that those of us who joined for that, by the time we leave this afternoon, we've recommitted ourselves to the community, to the cause.
It is something that is translatable to students and their campuses. And we realize, like, there are specific areas in the pro-life movement that we must engage in. If we're going to get
The people are coming up. And remember, where they said they stood, like, pro-life, pro-choice, no one can deny what was happening in that abortion is not violent. It's a violent act. It is needlessly a violent act. I think the other thing we have to keep in mind when we're talking about sexual education is kind of going back to what I said earlier and said, like,
there's one we're going to try to stop with this organization that wants to bring the destruction, of, like, a hundred women to our community. What do we need to stop that? I know that her is covered in the local newspaper, the paper that people reported anti-abortion activists, planned strategy to oppose Planned Parenthood coming to town. Instead of a handful of people coming, 400 people came that time. And it's been in churches across the country for 8 years. Because number 38 is the one in the town where I used to live in College Station, Texas. Number 38 was the facility that Abby used to direct. And being in town that day, I was living in Virginia, but I happened to be back in the community, and going out and standing in prayer the last day that facility was open before they closed their gates for the last time, before they tore their sign down. You've seen that iconic picture of the Planned Parenthood sign in town. Now, that's also
52% decline in abortion. Right? That year,
you understand, that is more locations than Home Depot, more locations than Target, more locations than Chick-fil-A. In fact, that's more locations than JCPenney and Kohl's combined. Locating here and then. That's one of our
US Congress, one by the Senate Judiciary Committee and the other by the House Select Investigative Panel. Both of those two congressional investigations each confirmed all of the major allegations of the videos and went even deeper and found even more widespread systemic wrongdoing at Planned Parenthood and their business partners in harvesting and selling baby body parts. Those congressional investigations led to over 15 criminal and regulatory referrals for Planned Parenthood and their business partners to federal law enforcement as well as state and local law enforcement. And just a month ago, it was finally announced that the U.S. Department of Justice is doing their job, following up on those criminal referrals, and Planned Parenthood and their business partners are now under federal criminal investigation.
Abortion workers leave their jobs and quit because of the people outside loving them. This is, I don't know how well you can see it, but this is the coronation of pregnancy report. In Indiana and many other states, the abortionist has to complete a form like this for every abortion that's done. And we can get a wealth of information from this document. There's no identifying information, so there are no HIPAA laws violated, the mother's name's not on it, or the rest of it's not on it, or the security number is not on it. But some of the things that we've learned from these reports is that underage abortions were being performed on little girls under the age of 14 in the state of Indiana and other places in this country. And they were never being reported to the authorities. So these little girls were being sent right back into the same situation without any authorities being notified so that their misery and the attacks on their precious little bodies would be stopped. We filed complaints on these kinds of violations, these egregious violations. Not one complaint did the job, but 2,000 complaints for this violation and many others finally got the attention of the people in charge of health regulations, and this abortionist was finally shut down. This three abortion facilities either had their facility license terminated, revoked, or he chose not to apply for a renewal. One of the reasons that this egregious abortion provider, Dr. Ulrich Hoffer, closed his doors is because in one of his facilities, in the basement, with only one stairway to get up and down, is where he had his procedure room. That's where the little babies were ripped apart, torn limb from limb, and discarded with surgical waste. When the inspectors went in, they found a regular household extension cord strung to a puddle of water, and that was providing the electricity that was operating the suction machine in that rat hole. Unless we find out these egregious violations and bring it to the attention of those in charge, these conditions will continue. Additional things that we find on a termination of pregnancy report are the name of the abortionist, the name of the facility, and abortionists who do abortions beyond the length of time that's allowed in that particular state. The next piece of information is a sample of a
program system. What do you think about success management? Well, of course it should be. Of course it should be. Of course, right? They have captured the culture. And I can tell you, it made it very easy for courts to then fall in line. Right? Now, if you take the obverse here, think about we in the pro-life movement have the law on our side. There's nothing in the Constitution that requires a right to abortion. We have science on our side. We know that's a lie from the sex. We have history, experience, common sense on our side. Right? So if we capture the culture, the law will follow. Okay. So that being said, winning the culture war is what will do the trick. I encourage you folks, we're doing everything we can to be proactive as we can to follow and fighting the battle in the courtroom. But don't wait for the little scroll on CNN or Fox News to say, everyone's pro-life now. That's everyone in this room's job, make that happen. Let me talk about some of the cases we have quickly so I can get some questions. Three cases that are current that I wanted to sort of use to let you know how we can impact the issue and what your role can be on sort of a retail politics or retail pro-life basis. So I think by retail, like one person, one person. NIFLA case that's going up to SCOTUS Supreme Court in March. We'll hear that case. That is a law out of California right here that essentially tells pro-life pregnancy clinics to put up advertisements for free abortions when people come into pro-life clinics. In other words, as soon as they come in, you have to tell them to go get a free abortion all over the state. Most of you can probably tell that's not only intuitively unfair, but also it's unconstitutional. You can't compel speech or not. What your role in this? When you look at court decisions, a lot of times courts will grant on to what we call the legislative record. They'll say, look, there's evidence in the record. There's a report from Narrower, an ancient common law, that says these PRCs, these pro-life clinics, are deceiving women. Right? And they latch on to that. That may be the only thing in the record. A real practical way you can affect these laws so that they don't get passed under the color of night, right, is show up at these hearings. I can't tell you how important that is. It sounds try to say be more politically engaged. Show up, believe me. These laws that we pass under nightfall, right? There should be a cost to pass laws that lead to the deaths of children. Okay? So show up for those. Another type of case is we've got a case called Bruning, City of Pittsburgh. That'll be going up to the Third Circuit Court of Appeal. That's what we call a buffer zone case. You've probably heard of those, where if you're doing for a lot of counseling or praying outside the pregnancy clinic, or a Planned Parenthood, rather, municipalities often try and cabin your ability to do that. They push you out to the periphery. Again, same type of counsel for me on that. Show up to be serious. It happens to be family, it happens to be serious.
Appealing and talking to people, taking flyers, talking. So you all heard about the 5 points this morning, right? 5 points. So what are some things that you can do all semester long? Well, I have some examples for you. Getting into effective education. You can host a Title IX training. Have any of you had a Title IX training at your school? No. So get in touch with Beth, our pregnant on campus coordinator. Learn about Title IX because so many students think, oh my goodness, I'm an athlete. I have to have an abortion because if I don't have this abortion, I'm going to lose my scholarship. I'm not going to be able to compete anymore, but that's not true. In fact, our senators don't even realize that's not true. Some of you were with us in Sacramento, and Senator Tanya Leyva stood in front of the entire Senate Education Committee and said, what about the girl who finds out that she's pregnant and thinks that she has to have abortion because she's going to lose her scholarship? And we looked at each other like, are you kidding me? That's against the law. Through Title IX, she can actually register. How do you not know that? So how do we educate our administrators on these things? You can host a Title IX training, and you can set up a meeting with your Title IX director on campus and say, we just want to make sure that you're educating the students on this when they're having these meetings. You can chalk and flyer. Hanging flyers. And I don't care if somebody is, every time you put up a flyer and somebody else is taking one down, you just put another flyer up. Just keep walking all day. I'm going to hang up all these flyers all across campus. You're going to follow me and take them down, I'm going to put a flyer on you too. And just keep going, you know? No, we're here and we're here to help. So I want everybody to know that. And I'm going to chalk on campus. And you're going to erase my
hand. Oh, hey, there we go. That's right. I got one person. I forgot. For sure. So in Missouri, we do things a little different. Of course, we have a little bit of a different culture out there. And how we do sidewalk counseling is that when a car pulls up, smile a little big, open ourselves up, and big old smile, and you approach the car and we say, hi, how are you doing today? We have free pregnancy tests and ultrasounds for you just right across the street, because we're awesome and we have a whole metal team across the street. And say, can you help me today? Right? Just like that. And a lot of people stop because they get me, that's pretty much a big man to share a car. I'm a big man. And a lot of people are actually very responsive to it. So it's really great. And the cool thing with that is that a lot of people do respond, and that kind of brings out the culture. Virtually anybody can be out there to do something like that. Simple Script is very awesome, it's very great, and we have a lot of success with that. So that's awesome. So how do we reduce the demand for abortion? We need to get out there on the sidewalk in front of the abortion clinics and to be able to sidewalk counsel. How many of you guys have been outside an abortion clinic before? Rock on, that's what I'm talking about. That's great, the majority of you, that's wonderful. How many people have actually gone out to the sidewalk to counsel before? Okay, great. So then why isn't everybody's hand up? It's a wonderful thing. So let me ask you this. Who in this room thinks they can bench the most? Bench the most, wait. You're a big dude, I'm going to point you out. Alright, what's your name?
Ryan.
Alright, Ryan. A lot of pressure. How much do you think you can bench?
I've never benched anything like
that. That's crazy. You do not help at all. That is great. Alright, how about this? Anybody work out? You work the room? No? Any athletes? You can run. Okay, that works. Great, perfect. Alright, so what do you run? So let me ask you this, right away, could you run a half marathon the very first day you start training?
No.
All right.
Thank you. Exactly. So running a marathon is just like getting out there on the sidewalk, just like sidewalk counseling. You're not going to run a marathon the very first time you start training. No. You have to exercise that. You have to get out there more and more and more. And it's got crazy amount of great benefits for you. The more that you are out there, the more exposed that you are, the more that people see you. And by expressing your pro-life views and being out there,
and how a particular piece of legislation is going to help reduce the demand for abortion. And the reason I want to encourage you with regard to pro-life legislation is I'm going to throw you out some numbers. In Mississippi, since they began a rash of enacting pro-life laws for really the last 2 decades, abortion has declined by 52%. In the state of Pennsylvania, by 24%. In South Carolina, by 34%. And in Michigan, by 21%. And many people who study this, you know, people who like math and run the statistics, has shown that this is directly attributable to the enactment of pro-life laws in those states. So I'm going to talk to you a little bit about demand side versus supply side. And I'm going to focus in on demand side. And what I mean by that is there's two different types of pro-life legislation. There's supply side, which reduces the number of abortion providers. And that can be things like abortion clinic regulations, or it can be things like abortion ban legislation.